Oh, yes, indeed. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at midday. This is Harvey Cook. The government says members of the armed forces could be called upon to drive ambulances and maintain border security to ease the impact of strikes this winter. The Conservative Party chair Nadeem Zahawi said a range of contingencies were being planned to deal with industrial action across the public sector. Labour says it would try to find a compromise with teachers to avert future strikes in schools. The Shadow Education Secretary Bridget Phillipson was asked on the BBC's Sunday with Laura Koonsberg programme if that would mean the 5% pay deal the government has offered or the 12% demanded by the unions. She said somewhere in the middle.
The unions are desperate to sit down around the table and have a conversation with ministers around this who are refusing to discuss pay. If I were Education Secretary, I'd be sat around the table trying to get a compromise. It's a process of negotiation. It's about pay, but it's also about terms and conditions. And what teachers tell me they feel is that they're demoralised, the government hasn't had their back.
The electrical retailer Currys says strikes at Royal Mail have forced it to drop the company and use alternative parcel delivery providers in the run-up to Christmas. Postal workers are due to hold more industrial action in the coming weeks in a dispute about pay and working practices. The US says the fighting in Ukraine is slowing down ahead of the winter months, but says there's no evidence of fading resistance from the Ukrainian forces. American intelligence believes that both sides will try to refit and resupply before any counter-offensives in the spring. Our correspondent in Kyiv, Jessica Parker, has been looking at what that could mean.
A very senior US official, intelligence official Avril Haines, says following the Russian retreat out of Kherson City, the fighting has been slowing down. Now seems to be concentrated really in the southeastern area of Donetsk. On critical infrastructure, Avril Haines was saying that despite those attacks that Moscow has been making on the energy grid, from what she could detect, it wasn't breaking the will of Ukrainians to resist.
The boss of one of the world's biggest energy firms says it will take years for prices to return to where they were before the war in Ukraine. Francesco Storace, who runs the Italian firm Enel, says the only way to bring down costs is investing in renewable power sources. The Royal Navy has come to the aid of four British workers at an isolated science base in the Antarctic after its buildings were buried in heavy snow. The team from HMS Protector took 2 days to get them out, as Charlotte Reid reports.
The staff at Port Lockroy had been working when the bad weather struck. In some places, the snow was 12 foot deep. The roof of a building, which houses the site's museum and gift shop, was damaged as well. Sailors and Royal Marines from the ship, the HMS Protector, came to their rescue. They helped out by clearing several tons of snow and carrying out some temporary repairs. The four women from the UK are there for 5 months to help manage the site, which includes counting penguins and running what's said to be the world's most remote post office.
Charlotte Reid reporting, and that's the BBC News at 3 minutes past midday.
Oh, thank you, Harvey.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.